on the tradition of their father, reggae legend Bob Marley. Yes. Yes. My next guest has created their own unique style of music. Here to perform Look Who's Dancing from their album One Bright Day, Ziggy Marley. That song made me hungry. I don't know what's wrong with me today, you know? Let's talk about that song. Did you write that?
Yeah, Look Who's Dancing, me and my brother Steve.
Yeah, why did you write that song? Tell me the message within that song.
Well, there's a message in the song meaning that, you know, for example, whoever has been down once in their life and is now up, mm-hmm. Look Who's Dancing now.
Yeah.
That mean, you know? You understand? Yeah. When South Africa is free, we will be saying, look who's dancing now.
Yeah.
Right.
Yeah, absolutely. Mm-hmm. Absolutely. Have you ever been
real down in your life? Did you write it because of a low point that you experienced?
Well, we write it for many things, really, you know. We experience go through life. I say my father go through life, my mother, my people, my parents. Mm-hmm. You know, so it really write off a whole heap of experience, not just one experience, you know.
Yeah.
Every people experience.
And like you said, even the South African experience, something that you're not experiencing, but you are aware of.
Yes.
It. Yeah. The New York Daily News, I think, described your album as dance music. Is that what you think, dance music, pretty much?
Yeah, we make music so that people can dance to it, you know. Mm-hmm. That we want to enjoy ourselves when we play music. Mm-hmm. We don't want to just sit down and be like this, you know, feel good. You know, so it's dance music, but it also has something else for your mind and for your heart, you know?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Work your butt and your mind.
Yeah, everything.
Yeah. We all are familiar with your dad's contribution to music. When I mentioned his name, the place went up for grabs. What contribution would you like to make to the music world?
Well, just to give the music that means something that people can relate to. For many years from now, 1,000 years from now, the music that I do will still live on, mm-hmm. you know, because it means something to people. It's not a music where, you know, something just lightly, something with meaning for many generations from now. Mm-hmm. Just as my father, music will go on for many more years.
Yeah. Yeah. Do you feel a lot of pressure because you are Ziggy Marley, the son of Bob?
Well, no, not really, you know. We grew up into the music mm-hmm. business, really. My father is a musician, my mother, my grandmother, my auntie, my uncle, my nephew, my niece. Mm-hmm. The whole family is music, mm-hmm. you know. So what we're doing now, we only do it naturally. And so from doing it within myself, mm-hmm. out of myself, then there can be no real pressure from outside forces.
Right.
Because what I have inside of me is that keep me.
Yes.
And that, yeah, keep me going, you know. Mm-hmm.
Let's see if I can think of something else to ask you that they'll clap for at the end of your response. You have relatives of yours in the band. Now, who was related to you back then?
Two sisters, Sidel and Sharon and Steve, was uh-huh. DJing and singing.
Right. Yeah. You all argue a lot, like most brothers and sisters, about your musical stuff?
Well, no, not about the music, but sometimes the girls will argue about clothes, you know?
Yeah. Stuff that you wear on stage?
Yeah, the girls, really.
Yeah. So they fight about it. They yeah. really get into it. Yes. Well, I'm enjoying the stuff that I've heard off the album. It's getting a lot of airplay. And I wish you continued success with all this.
Thank you, man.
Hang tough, man.
Yeah, respects.
It's a pleasure. Ziggy Marley. We'll be back with Bob Guccione. I'm so hungry.